Hello friends, welcome to EPG Pathshala. This is Dr. R. Balasashireka, Assistant Professor, Department of Food Science and Nutrition, Avinashlingam Institute for Home Science and Higher Education for Women, Coimbatore. Today we are going to see the module on consequences of high and low fat intake. The main function of fat in the body is to provide energy. About 18 to 24% of body weight in women and 15 to 18% of body weight in men is body fat. Fats spare proteins from being used as energy and allow them to perform their body building and tissue repairing functions. Fats on oxidation provide almost twice the amount of energy, that is 9 kilocalories per gram compared with that of carbohydrates and proteins. Fats also help in forming structure of cells and tissues of the cell membrane. Fats help to carry and metabolize the fat-soluble vitamins A, D, E and K in the intestine. Some fat also supply essential fatty acids. Good fat helps to protect the heart and keeps the body healthy, and bad fat damages the heart and increases the risk. After completing this module, you will be learning about the types of lipoproteins and its effect, the role of fat in the body, namely monounsaturated fatty acid, polyunsaturated fatty acids, and the consequences of high fat diet and low fat diet. First, we will look into the role of fat in the body and diet. Fat is present both in outer and internal membrane of the cell. Internal membranes include nucleus, endoplasmic reticulum, and other membrane-bound organelles. Fat in the form of globules of triglycerides is stored in specialized type of fat cells known as adipocytes within the adipose tissue. Omega-6 and omega-3 unsaturated fatty acids act as a precursor for hormone-like substances. Examples include eicosanoids, which help to regulate blood pressure, control certain aspects of reproductive cycle and induction of blood clotting. Overproduction of certain prostaglandins from arachidonic acid causes blood clotting and narrow down the arteries. The consequences can be reduced by EPA and DHA found in fish oil. The subcutaneous fat beneath the skin act as an insulating material for the body and prevent heat loss. Too thick fat may reduce heat loss from the skin and produces discomfort. Fat deposits around the vital organs like heart and kidney help to hold them in position and protect from physical shock. Fat, depending on the size and composition of the meal, leaves the stomach slowly and delays the onset of hunger and gives a feeling of satiety. The presence in the fat adds flavor and texture to the food. Coming to the role of polyunsaturated fatty acids. The important polyunsaturated fatty acids include alpha-linolenic acid, eicosapentaenoic acid abbreviated as EPA, docosahexaenoic acid abbreviated as DHA. The omega-6 or N6 polyunsaturated fatty acids include linoleic acid and arachidonic acid. Restriction of fatty acids may lead to mental depression. Hence, fatty acid restriction must be avoided in the diet. The ICMR recommendation of polyunsaturated fatty acids to saturated fatty acid is 0.8:10. Arachidonic acid are the precursors of prostacyclins, which act as vasodilators, thromboxanes, which act as vasoconstrictor, and leukotrienes. These help in the prevention of formation of thrombus. PUFA contains antiplatelet aggregate factor and hence decrease the sticking of platelets and reduce thrombosis. Linoleic acid plays a significant role in the transport of cholesterol by preventing the accumulation in walls of the blood vessels. PUFA help in cholesterol esterification. PUFA prevents the incidence of coronary heart disease by decreasing the synthesis of VLDL. It also decreases the synthesis of LDL and triglyceride levels. PUFA reduces the risk of Alzheimer's disease. It reduces inflammation, inhibits platelet activity, decreases oxidative stress, exert antiarrhythmic effects and improve triglyceride levels. Role of omega-3 fatty acids. Omega-3 fatty acids are cardioprotective. EPA and DHA increase the fluidity across the cell membranes of cardiac cells. It prevents atrial fibrillation and reduces the binding of inflammatory cytokines to receptors. They improve blood lipoprotein levels, decrease the risk of arrhythmia, lower plasma triglycerides. It reduces the risk of myocardial infarction and ischemic heart disease among women. It reduces blood clotting due to the beneficial effect on platelet activities. It prevents breast and colon cancer by inhibiting tumor cell growth. It helps in the formation of prostaglandins. Prostaglandins helps in the transmission of genetic information through generations. It acts as a detoxifying agent by making the cell membrane more permeable. This permeability protects the cells against infectious bacteria and virus. It facilitates the permeability of nutrients and other waste materials in and out of the cell. It reduces the chances of asthma and also acts as an anti-aging factor. Role of monounsaturated fatty acids. Monounsaturated fatty acids include oleic acid and erucic acid. It helps in increasing HDL cholesterol levels, lower LDL and do not act on triglycerides. Monounsaturated fatty acids play a role in thrombosis and is anti-inflammatory. It leads to cellular damage due to uncontrolled peroxidation of PUFA in cell membrane while maintaining a balance with monounsaturated fatty acid. It decreases LDL oxidative susceptibility and decreases the risk of coronary heart disease when a diet low in fat and high in monounsaturated fatty acid is eaten. Now let me see the foods rich in polyunsaturated fatty acid. It includes fish, particularly salmon, mustard oil, flaxseed oil, canola oil, soybean oil, walnuts, groundnut, rice bran oil, walnut, poppy seed and peanut butter. The foods rich in monounsaturated fatty acid include olive oil, canola, almond oil, groundnut oil, corn, sesame, peanut, grapeseed, safflower, avocado and whole grain wheat. Now we will move on to the disorders of the plasma lipoproteins. Inherited defects of lipoprotein metabolism include both hyperlipoproteinemia and hypolipoproteinemia. Hyperlipoproteinemia and hypolipoproteinemia. Excess or deficit amount of plasma lipoproteins may lead to this condition. Based on plasma triglyceride level and cholesterol levels, and on the pattern in plasma lipoprotein electrophoresis, it is classified into type 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 hyperlipoproteinemia. The different types of lipoproteinemia with their cause, effect, effect of electrophoresis and defect is given in the table. Type 1 hyperlipoproteinemia. It is due to increased chylomicron genetic deficiency of lipoprotein lipase. It increases the plasma triglyceride levels. And on electrophoresis, a chylomicron band is seen. And the patients suffer from eruptive xanthomas. Next, type 2A. It is due to hypercholesterolemia. where elevated plasma LDL levels are seen and on electrophoresis, beta-lipoprotein band is observed. It increased risk of developing atherosclerosis and myocardial infarction at early age. Type 2B. There is elevated plasma LDL and VLDL levels. Pre-beta-lipoprotein band and beta-lipoprotein band is evidenced through electrophoresis. Type 3 is also known as broad beta disease or floating beta lipoprotein. It is due to the abnormality of ApoE, which interferes with clearance of chylomicrons and VLDL remnants by liver, due to which elevated plasma triglyceride and cholesterol levels are observed. On electrophoresis, broad band between normal beta lipoprotein and pre-beta lipoprotein is observed. Increased risk of atherosclerosis in coronary arteries and peripheral vessels are observed. Coming to type 4, it is due to the overproduction of VLDL, due to which there is elevated plasma triglyceride levels. On electrophoresis, pre-beta lipoprotein band is evident, associated with coronary heart disease and diabetes mellitus. Type 5, which is a rare disorder, is due to the overproduction of chylomicrons and VLDL. There is plasma triglyceride levels elevated. On electrophoresis, chylomicrons and pre-beta lipoprotein band is observed. The effect is unknown. Coming to hypolipoproteinemia, the first type is A-beta lipoproteinemia. It is due to the absence of beta lipoprotein in plasma, inability to synthesize apolipoprotein B100. So, chylomicrons and VLDL are absent. The next one is alpha lipoproteinemia or Tangier's disease, which is caused due to the defect in HDL biogenesis. Plasma HDL, cholesterol and phospholipid is either low or absent. Enlarged tonsils with orange discoloration, accumulation of cholesterol esters in tissues, overproduction of triglycerides due to absence of ApoC2 leading to hypertriacylglycerolemia. Foods included and avoided for hyperlipoproteinemia. Foods included skim milk, non-fat dry milk, buttermilk, vegetables like beets, broccoli, cabbage, carrot, greens, onion, mushroom, etc. Fruits include apple, banana, berries, dates, figs, grapes, melon, papaya, orange and pineapple. Poultry without skin, chicken, fish, veal with lean cuts, walnuts, oil from corn, sesame, soybeans and sunflower are the foods to be consumed. The foods avoided include whole milk, condensed milk, homogenized milk, canned milk, sweet cream, ice cream, whole milk yogurt and cheese, skin of chicken, coconut, butter, other margarine and solid shortenings are to be avoided. Consequences of high fat intake. Carbohydrates, proteins and fats, the three vital macronutrients are required in sufficient quantities to keep our body healthy. Among the three, carbohydrates and fats supply energy and must be consumed in right quantities. If there is excessive intake of fat and carbohydrates, it may cause complications such as diabetes, cancer, obesity, heart problems, etc. Let me see one by one in detail. Atherosclerosis. One of the most serious effects of elevation of plasma lipoproteins is the disease of the arteries, atherosclerosis. It leads to coronary heart disease and stroke. Accumulation of cholesterol esters on the inner surface on the arterial walls forms atherosclerotic plaques. This narrows down the arterial lumen and reduces the blood flow. The cells and tissues become anoxic because of the reduced flow of oxygen and dye. Atherosclerosis occurs in any of the arteries of the body, but it most frequently occurs in the coronary arteries. the reduced blood flow results in the myocardial infarction and is termed as heart attack. The persons with atherosclerosis have high levels of plasma LDL and low levels of plasma HDL. A strong association between LDL and atherosclerosis exists, and hence LDL is termed as bad cholesterol. Conversely, high levels of plasma HDL protects against coronary heart disease. Hence, HDL is known as good cholesterol. HDL also aids in removing excess cholesterol from the blood and extrahepatic tissues. They are transported to the liver and degraded through reverse cholesterol transport system. Thus, HDL cholesterol prevents the onset of atherosclerosis. Obesity. Consumption of high calorie diet than the requirement hastens obesity. At the end of carbohydrate metabolism, carbohydrate gets converted to glucose and the excess gets converted and stored in liver and muscles in the form of glycogen. Human body has the capacity to store only a limited quantity of glycogen, and the remaining gets converted to fat and is stored in adipose tissue. Brain injury. Foods rich in high saturated fat disturbs the energy balance, damaging the hypothalamus of the brain. Consumption of high fat triggers brain damage by bringing changes in proteins and genes of the brain. Heart disease. Intake of dietary fat is directly associated to heart disease through a process called atherosclerosis. Free radicals are those with a single electron and are highly reactive. Free radicals on circulation in the blood snatch or grab electrons away from other molecules or cells that line the arteries. Free radicals eventually narrow the arteries and lead to the formation of cholesterol-rich deposits called plaques. These plaques in the coronary arteries rupture and spill its debris or contents into the blood and cause blockage. The supply of food and oxygen to the arteries decreases, and eventually part of the heart dies, known as heart attack. Heart disease generally occurs above the age of 40 in men and after menopause in women. Stroke. This is the third leading cause of death. The two types of stroke are hemorrhagic stroke and ischemic stroke. Hemorrhagic stroke is caused due to the bleeding in the brain. The ischemic stroke is caused due to the blockage in the artery and accounts to 75%. They are caused by cerebral thrombosis, blockage in brain artery, fat-related atherosclerosis, and ruptured plaque. Cancer. High-fat diet is associated with colon cancer and breast cancer and accounts for 1 lakh deaths per year. It also causes cancer of prostate, pancreas, lung among non-smokers, and malignant melanoma. Cancer risk may be due to free radicals. Eating a high-fat diet increases the free radicals in the blood. They had to snatch electrons from the artery walls and cause heart attack or stroke. If this does not happen, they grab electrons from the chromosomes. Chromosomes can self-repair themselves. But if they prolong to be damaged continuously for years together, cellular repair mechanism get increased and results in cancer. Hypertension. Blood pressure above the normal levels is known as hypertension. It is one of the major risk factors for heart disease and stroke. Extra calories in the form of high fat diet may lead to this condition. Heart must work and pump the blood harder through all the tissues as the weight increases. So, the pumping of the heart increases the blood pressure. Diabetes. Diabetes mellitus is nothing but the inability to metabolize sugar due to the improper secretion of insulin, a pancreatic hormone. It may be of two types. In type 1 diabetes, the pancreas completely stops producing insulin. And in type 2 diabetes, the production of insulin may be normal, but the fat deposited prevents the body to use the insulin efficiently. So, type 2 diabetes is closely associated with obesity. Arthritis. The excess fat leads to excess weight among humans. It is one of the most causes for a common form of arthritis known as osteoarthritis. The wear and tear of the major joints is high in those consuming a high-fat diet. Another form of arthritis is rheumatoid arthritis, that is, crippling of the joint disease. An increased risk of rheumatoid arthritis is due to high-fat diet, and in certain cases, the condition may be reversed by low-fat diet. Now, let me move on to the consequences of low-fat diet. Poor brain function. For the optimal functioning of the brain, it requires a steady supply of fatty acids, as the brain is largely made up of fat. Cholesterol acts as a special protective factor in brain. Cholesterol acts as an important brain nutrient, which is essential for the functioning of neurons and neurotransmitters. Basically, cholesterol is the fuel supplier for brain, as the functioning unit neurons can by themselves cannot produce cholesterol for energy. Cholesterol must be supplied only through the diet as a source of energy. Studies have shown that intake of high cholesterol is associated with better cognitive performance, including abstract reasoning, diverted attention, memory, and word fluency. Intake of cholesterol is also associated with better job performance, high energy, and changes in mood known as brain fog. Due to these reasons, health foods are boosted with healthy fats. Poor vitamin absorption. Low-fat diet interfere with the absorption of fat-soluble vitamins like A, D, E, and K. These are fat-soluble nutrients and require fat for their metabolism and utilization. Fat-soluble vitamins are stored mostly in the liver and fat tissue. They are essential for bodily functions like growth, cell repair, immunity, and blood clotting. Fats required for the body to utilize these vitamins, or they may get excreted, disposing to risk for vitamin deficiency. Heart health. Inflammation is the grassroots for most diseases. Inflammation is closely associated with heart health than that of high intake of fat or cholesterol. Inflammatory diet includes too much of sugar, refined carbohydrates, poor quality proteins, saturated fat, and processed vegetable oils. These foods are heart-threatening. Conversely, anti-inflammatory foods which contain healthy fats is heart-friendly. Heart-friendly foods include dietary monounsaturated fatty acids. They help to lower lipid profile, blood cholesterol levels, mediate blood pressure, improve insulin sensitivity, and regulate blood sugar level. Mediterranean diet is glorified with high fat and extra virgin olive oil, nuts, and fish. The diet contains extra calories than the recommended allowances of total calories. 8. This diet helps in reducing cardiovascular diseases, diabetes mellitus, and weight gain. Intake of saturated fat may raise the blood cholesterol levels. Both low carbohydrate diet with higher levels of saturated fat is not associated with increase in blood cholesterol levels and may have a beneficial effect on cardiovascular disease risk markers. Hormone imbalance, including sex hormones, testosterone, and estrogen. Hormone balance can be attained naturally by eating diet with enough fat. Cholesterol and other fat substances help in building cellular membranes and hormones. The role of fat as antioxidants and precursors for brain-supporting molecules and neurotransmitters is noteworthy. Vitamin D acts more as an antioxidant than like a vitamin, along with other sex hormones like testosterone and estrogen. Low-fat diet increases the risk of infertility and other hormonal imbalances in women. Low-fat diet also tend to cause menstrual symptoms and problems and difficulty getting pregnant. Weight gain and overeating. Association between fat intake, hormones and weight management is on the talk in recent years. Dieting regains all the weight lost with a short span of life. This is because the weight lost brings about a decline in energy expenditure, that is adaptive thermogenesis, and increases hunger. Both together help in regain of weight. But consumption of high fat with low carbohydrates prevents this type of weight regain. This is because high fat in diet satiates and prevents hunger signals and appetite. Ghrelin hormone levels help burn the fat in the body. Low carb, high fat diet help in burning most calories and improved insulin sensitivity. Both the resting energy expenditure and total energy expenditure were lowest in the low fat diet group and highest in low carb diet. Insulin resistance and diabetes. Excess weight gain is related with insulin. Insulin can be controlled by eating plenty of healthy fat. Insulin is referred to as fat storing hormone. It helps usher glucose into our cells and help control the blood sugar levels after a carbohydrate-rich meal. Different types of fat have various effects on insulin. Appropriate level of fat in the diet is a challenge for controlling diabetes. Low-fat, high-carb diet pose a risk for insulin resistance and gain body weight. Both monounsaturated and polyunsaturated fatty acid improves insulin sensitivity by modifying the composition of cell membrane. Replacement of saturated fat with unsaturated fat has a significant effect on insulin sensitivity. Also, diets rich in fat are lower in carbohydrates and sugar and has a beneficial effect on controlling diabetes. Insulin resistance is associated with weight loss diet. Weight loss cannot be experienced by consuming a diet that is not healthy, particularly with insulin resistance. Low-fat diet diminishes weight loss, in particular with insulin resistance, women compared with that of low-carb diet. Depression and anxiety. The important role of fat in functioning of the brain is to control mood swings. Food rich in fat act as an anti-depression diet. Fatty acids synthesize endocannabinoids, a neurotransmitter, and affect the central nervous system. Trans fat intake raises the risk of depression, and intake of monounsaturated fatty acids, polyunsaturated fatty acids, and olive oil may lower the depression risk. Diet rich in fat lowers depression and other mental disorders. Omega-3 fatty acids in the diet is more effective in improving the depression symptoms disorder. Gut-related problems. High fat diet along with high fiber diet is associated with healthy gut environment or microbiome. Healthy gut, nourished with plenty of naturally occurring fatty acids and nutrients, supplies the building blocks to a healthy brain, both of which are interrelated through brain-body connection. A blood sugar controlled diet balances the gut bacteria as well. Eating plenty of high fiber plant foods by inclusion of vegetables along with fat nourishes the gut bacteria, maintains a correct balance and lowers inflammation. Coconut oil in particular protects the gut health and is easily digested even by those with chronic digestive issues. These are certain consequences of high and low fat diet. To conclude, the fats that we must obtain from our diet include the saturated fats, that is long chain and medium chain, monounsaturated fats and polyunsaturated fats, especially omega 3 and some omega 6. Different fats have various effect in human body. Saturated fats, certain polyunsaturated fatty acids and monounsaturated fatty acids should form the bulk of our diet. The polyunsaturated fatty acids, also referred as omega 3 fatty acids in particular, eicosapentaenoic acid and docosahexaenoic acid, and the omega 6 fatty acids in particular, arachidonic acid, should be a part of the regular diet. Omega 6 linoleic acid from whole foods are more beneficial than from refined vegetable oils and include nuts, seeds and avocados. Sources from refined vegetable oils are from sunflower, safflower, corn, etc. The ratio of carbohydrate, protein and fat in the diet varies with the level of physical activity, age, sex and medical conditions. Ideally, 40% of the calories must be from carbohydrates, 30% each from protein and healthy fats. A low-fat, high-carb diet is recommended than a high-fat diet, as this may lead to sugar cravings. Thank you.